Hey, how's it going, everyone? Welcome back to Emnix Plays Path of Exile Prophecy League. We are back after a couple days of no recording, so I know there hasn't been any episodes for maybe 2 days or so. And you know, it's a combination of life, of semi-traumatic experience from dying to Malachi, and from the fact that I recorded a few episodes and they got corrupted, so I couldn't upload them. So overall, this whole weekend was sort of a train wreck in terms of YouTube episodes, very similar to the 2005 movie Fantastic Four, starring Miles Teller, who coincidentally also starred in the 2004 movie Divergent, which was also kind of not good. But yeah, you know, we're back now. We're ready to go full force. Well, actually, no, I wouldn't say full force. I suspect we haven't been going full force for a while now. You know, with it being summer, being more busy at work and all of that stuff, it's just really hard to find enough time to record, you know, 2 or 3 episodes every day. Anyways, there's no point in giving any excuses. We are back to playing Path of Exile, back to playing this build. I'm still not done with this build. Some of you might be tired of this build already. I am sorry. I am not tired of it just yet. One thing I do want to say is that we probably will try to participate in the racing season. For those of you who do not know, starting this Thursday, this Friday, I believe, the new racing season will begin, the Medallion League, or the Medallion season. It looks pretty interesting. I'm not too interested in the rewards overall, but they do have some interesting races, some new races that I do want to try out. The Medallion race, Cutthroat is back, all kinds of stuff that I am excited to do. You know, it's a summertime, and this is around the time when all the cool stuff, all the cool games get released. You know, you got Civilization VI coming in a few months. You got what else is there? No Man's Sky, is that coming out soon as well? That looked interesting at the time. But yeah, speaking of new games coming out, you know, this weekend was sort of, or I guess last Friday was the release of Pokemon Go. Really only in sort of half the world, but let's be real here, it was pretty much released for the whole world. I live in Canada, and it did not officially get released on Android or on the Play Store in Canada. However, you could always go and download the installer file and play it all the same. So that's exactly what I did. And before I knew it, I was just completely addicted. It got me going outside, you know. I found myself outside in downtown Toronto at like 11:30 p.m. just walking around trying to catch just one more Poliwhirl or Poliwag, I believe. And you know, all those Pidgeys and all those Rattatas, you know, I got it, dog. Like I'm ready. So yeah, these days, you know, when I find myself, you know, kind of bored with nothing to do, I just end up going out, taking a walk, you know, at least for the last 2 or 3 days, and catching some Pokemon. For those of you who don't know, how the Pokemon or how this Pokemon game works is it's a mobile app or a mobile game, where it's based on augmented reality, and by that I mean you follow a GPS and walk around your city, walk around your area, wherever, and certain areas would be hotspots or Pokestops with certain landmarks, whether that would be, you know, a piece of art or, you know, your local post office or whatever, you know, somewhere with a little bit of significance to your city. And through that, you know, you walk around the city, you catch Pokemon. It's very similar to, you know, walking in tall grass and catching Pokemon, for those of you who've actually played the Pokemon game. And then, you know, very little to do with battle. It's more just getting you outside. Apparently there's a social aspect to it. I don't really see where the social aspect comes from, but they say it's there. I'm not sure. And yeah, it's pretty fun, you know, just to, you know, get yourself out of the house, just to relive the nostalgia of your childhood. For those of you who were young enough to play Pokemon Red and Pokemon Blue, I guess they still release Pokemon every year. Do people still play it? I don't even know. But apparently it's been crazy successful. Like the first week, you know, it was like the open beta of or the initial release of an MMORPG or something. The servers kept going down like every 30 minutes, and you know, you have to wait like 10-20 minutes just to log back on. Every two Pokemon you catch, your game would crash. Bugs everywhere, and yet people still love it. You know, I'm walking down the street, and I can just you can kind of tell who are the people that are playing Pokemon Go. You know, they'd be walking down the street, and all of a sudden they come to a dead stop, right? Like, if you weren't paying attention, you would run right into these people, and they start swiping at their phones. You know, oh, this person, you know, this person got his next drowsy. You know, he's about to catch that drowsy, and he's throwing those Pokeballs like it's nobody's business. But yeah, I mean, lots of people are into it, and I gotta tell you, I am too. You know, I'm down with this idea. I have a couple friends who haven't bought in just yet. You know, they'll give in soon enough, I suspect. They will. Anyways, back to Path of Exile, back to our build. So like I was saying, after our death to Malachi, I had actually recorded a few episodes, and the game crashed, and somehow my videos got corrupted, so I couldn't upload them. So this is actually, let's do a quick summary. We are level 86, level 86 at 25%. In terms of our challenges, we are at 21 challenges. Very recently, I have completed the Kill Beyond Demons. We have killed 5 out of 6, which completes this challenge. I still haven't gone back for Merciless Malagaro. Not Malagaro, Merciless Malachi. We will do it eventually. I just don't know when. I don't know how, but we will do it. Those one-shot mechanics, I mean, they're... I want to say they're awful. At the same time, they're awesome. I kind of like the way... I don't know how I want to say this. I kind of like the way that I set up my death penalty. It sucks that, you know, I really don't want to die. When I die, I have to spend all this money to rebuy my items. But at the same time, I get to veil my shit. Like, who doesn't get excited when they're, like, veiling their stuff? You know what I mean? It's like getting a new toy and someone goes, hey, I'm going to give you a chance right now. You can either make your toy better or, and like 100 times better. Or this toy can just go into trash. And it's like, I could make my toy better. Like, you know, it could be anything. It could even be a boat. So, you know, the fact that we're doing Veil Orbs, all, you know, just buying more into the RNG of this game. Some people might not like it too much, but I am down. I am totally down. At the same time, you know, when we die, we lose EXP. When we die, we lose a little bit of our ego. I don't know. In a way, it's titillating to know that, oh, at any moment you can die. But I don't... And it's kind of rewarding to die in a way. I mean, it's better than hardcore where it's like you die and everything's gone. I purposely chose to keep my, you know, not corrupt my gems, not delete my gems. Just if I have to delete my items, I will. So in a way, it's like semi-rewarding, but not really at the same time. It has some risk-reward aspect to it, I suppose. I really like the way I do that. And I think from now on, you know... Oh! Bearers. You gotta be careful of those. I don't know if that would have killed me, but I mean, it's killed me enough times that I don't want to find out, you know? Frost bearers. That could have... Let's... Okay, so one of them doesn't do all that much damage, but... Who knows how much, like, a bunch of them would have done. Alright, Xana mission complete. How many monsters left? Still quite a few. All right. But like I was saying, you know, we don't want to die. But when we do die, it's not the worst thing. You get a little bit, you get nuggets of hope when you die. You're like, well, I'm about to lose my items, but at least, or I lost all my EXP and I'm about to lose my items, but at least there's a chance that I get one good item out of this. Like, there's a chance. Not that it has happened. I don't think I've ever veiled a good item yet. Is it even possible? I don't know. Do I even have any good veils that I want? I guess that's a real question. The answer might be no, you know? But, you know, there's a chance. And that's all I want. I just want a chance. Oh, hoo, 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 hoo. Stuff is hurting. But we lived. Okay, so we got a graveyard map, some belts, a superior molten shell, and some other crap. Let's go back first, sell all this stuff. And then go on with our day. Okay, instead of selling, so what I have been doing, for jewelry and belts and stuff, I ID it on the spot. So these belts, I'm going to ID them. This one is... Nah, not good enough. Is it good enough? It's not really good enough. This one's definitely not good enough. And everything else, I kind of just deposit to ID later. So all my chest armors, let's deposit those. All the gloves. And if I don't get anything out of it, you know, I just save it for the chaos recipe. Some one-handers over here. Oh no, it's a wand. Let's put the wand here. Shields. And this way I can save some time too, you know? Okay. And then sell all this other crap. And then have some currency. Have some maps. What is this? A tier 5 graveyard. A tier 4 tunnel. Some cards. And superior molten shell. Alright, we're done with that. Let's go back into Xana's map. There's still 20 monsters left. I don't know if I am too interested in clearing those 20 monsters, but at the very least, let's pick up these items. 20 monsters. Can I be arsed to do it? Honestly, I'm that guy who's like 20 out of 400. I mean, that's like 99%. I know it's not 199%, but it's like close enough, you know? 20 out of 400, whatever, man. It's like, what, 2 out of 40? 120? It's like 5%. It's 5% left? No, I'm not doing it. You can't make me. I'm not sticking around. Goodbye. So let's quickly talk about, you know, what are the things we still need to do? What are our goals? You know, we always, anybody ask you what your goals in life are, you better have something ready. Unless you're young and free. Like, in which case, I don't know, you can be part of a Snoop Dogg song. What the hell is this? No, you know, sometimes, you know, you can still be high school, or you can still... Be in a spot where, you know, you don't exactly have a goal yet. You're still out there searching, which is fine too. You know, there's nothing wrong with that. But in this game right now, you know, we're at this point where we're like a month and a half into the game now, almost a month and a half. We should have some goals, and we do have like our long term goal, right? We want 24 challenges. We want maybe 26, 27. We want to get as many challenges as we can. Really, that's about it. So how do we go about accomplishing that? Well, I tried killing Malachi. That didn't work out too well. We still have to do the 1,000 monsters in a single rampage kill streak. We need some friends to come do that with us. I got a mountain ledge map ready. We can give that a try later. What else is there? Fulfill prophecy types. I mean, I'm still doing a lot of prophecies. There's still a lot ready. I got this one Rogue Exile in a strong box. We got this Feral Lord one. We gotta find one of them Arid Lake maps. Is there one right now? Arcade, Museum, Pier, Canyon, Orchard. Not really. Promenade. Is Promenade part of our rare maps challenge? It is not. Okay. What else can we do? A series chosen. We can do this quest. A series chosen is a what map? It's like a what map is a series chosen? It's a residence, I think. Let me double check. A series chosen POE. It is a Veil Pyramid map, which is a tier 3 map. I have a yellow Veil Pyramid right here. Inhabited by Goatmen, they have more life, they cannot be stunned, and the boss deals extra damage. I am okay with that. Let's do that map, and then we'll be done with one more challenge, and we'll only have two more to go. I guess that's the goal for today, and I am okay with that. Let's go activate the map, and let's get into it. At this point, I feel like, you know, the league is pretty much done for a lot of people. It isn't for me, for obvious reasons, simply due to the fact that we have not yet accomplished our goals yet. And, you know, if you can't finish what you started, maybe you shouldn't start it at all, you know? So, you know, let's keep this up. At this rate, we're going to be able to finish our 24 out of 40 or whatever. Or 26 out of 40. I'm very hopeful. And I'm optimistic. I don't know if we'll get to 30. 30 might be a little bit difficult. But I mean, we'll give it the old college try, you know? Oh, God. Stuff is hurting. What are the mods? Why does it hurt so much? Why do we have so much HP? Okay, we're good. We're good. Okay. Obviously, we don't have the clear speeds that our friends do. You know, there are some people out there. And not just our friends, some of our viewers too. And honestly, if you came here to watch me clear stuff very quickly, oh, buddy, you are at the wrong channel. Let me just tell you that right now. You're not here to watch a guy play well. You know, I can tell you that much. Or I hope you're not here to watch a guy play well. You can come and watch a normal guy, you know, improve on his trade. Which is fine. I applaud you for it, but. I hope you didn't come here and expect fine play. Okay, Orb of Storms. I thought I saw bearers again. If anything, you came to watch suboptimal play, which is I can accept that. You know, I can. Ooh, a promenade. Thank you. And you know, if you want to give some advice on how to play better, I'll take it. You know, I'll take your criticism to heart. Or your constructive comments. But yeah. Besides Path of Exile, I'm thinking of releasing one more game. As a regular lineup to, you know, what we currently have on the docket. Now we have Path of Exile Prophecy League. We're going to have Path of Exile Racing, which honestly, it's not going to be played too often since I just don't have time to get home. You know, I still have a full-time job. I work a 9-to-5. By the time I get back, you know, most of the day is over and I, you know, I got to have dinner, all that stuff, all that lonely bachelor life stuff that I have to do when I get home. But I will try to make these races. As well as play, you know, this is my utmost priority right now. Getting all the challenges, finalizing this build. This build, I want to say it's done, but at the same time, I know it can be a lot stronger. So I'm not too happy with it just yet. You know, we're dying to all these bosses, and I feel like we shouldn't be. And a lot of people tell me, it's like, you know, everybody dies to these bosses. You just gotta kill them before they kill you. And that's not what I want to do, though. I want to stand there and slowly wither them away before they can kill me. Or even as they're killing me, you know? I want to be able to tank all the hits. That's why I picked something with so much strength. But obviously, you need to layer your defense. That's what's most important in this game. So, you know, well, we'll have to see. We'll have to see. Hopefully, there's enough room where we can take the character to a point where he just doesn't die to anything. I mean, maybe it's just going to take another build. Who knows, right? Either way, compared to last league, compared to Talisman... Wait, Talisman wasn't the last league. Compared to Perandis, we have been doing a lot better. In part, it has to do with the fact that we stopped doing weird hipster builds like Wild Strike. Does Wild Strike even belong in a hipster category? I don't even know anymore. It might just belong in like the extinct category. You know, there's like meta builds, there's like hipster builds, and there's like extinct builds. There's like fossil builds. Wild Strike might be a fossil build. I don't know. Someone will have to prove me wrong. I have seen a couple decent Wild Strike builds online. I don't know if they can clear like big boss maps. And really, I'm not interested in fast clearing builds. I'm interested in killing like big bosses. You know, being able to run a tier 50 map. It doesn't matter if I can't afford one. But just the fact that I can, you know, it's on principle. It's what matters to me. So, anyways, we seem to be doing pretty well in the map itself. No real problems. None that I can see. We never really got low. Like a Flow Rider song. But, you never know. Things can change very quickly in this game. And knock on wood, hope it doesn't actually happen. Oh god. Stuff's happening. Alright. We're good. A shrine, a massive shrine. That's good. Lots of AoE. Okay. The inventor. Cool. Anything here? No. But yeah, you know, it's summertime. What's everyone else been up to? You know, summer's pretty much the time when everyone starts going on vacations. You know, a lot more YouTube content is being consumed nowadays. You know, people wake up, they got nothing to do, they want to watch some Sunday TV. I mean, let me be real with you guys. Like, that's what I used to do as a kid, right? I would go on summer vacation. Summer vacation, and I would wake up, watch like Saturday morning TV or weekday morning TV or whatever the fuck it is. Oh, boss time. And like, you know, that's your day, right? And you go outside, ride your bike, have fun with friends, whatever, go on vacation. Nowadays, like, do people still watch TV? I'll be real with you guys. I haven't watched TV in like, do I need to full clear this map? Maybe not. No, I think we're good. So now we're at 22 challenges. But yeah, like I said, I haven't watched TV in like a good 7 to 8 years. Like, I haven't subscribed to cable. Everything I watch is either YouTube content or Netflix. You know? Does Netflix count as TV? Kinda, not really. But, I accidentally identified all my shit. Oh well. Any of this good?
Not really.
But yeah, what do kids do these days? You know, it's been a while since I've subscribed to, well, not subscribed, but since I've had any contact with anyone under the age of 20, I want to say. Do people just go to camp now? Is that a thing? Is that what people do? You know, I have had some people from the Discord channel. And for those of you who don't know, if you scroll down to the description bar below, there's a Discord channel you can join to hang out. You know, there are a lot of people on all the time. It's summer vacation. There's always somebody playing Path of Exile. Come hang out. Talk to us. We're all nice. I'm nice. Anyways. But yeah, what do people do in the summer? Somebody let me know, man. I haven't had a summer vacation in years. Okay, and some of you might be wondering right now, why are you just hovering over this as of my peak? Well, you curious bugger, I do believe. Yeah, I have this thing. I have a prophecy. You will defeat the Gemling Legionnaires while wearing Azimite Peak. First of all, who the fuck are the Gemling Legionnaires? Oh, I think I know who they are. Are they the ones in the marketplace? Warehouse District, that's right. Okay, sure. Oh, shit. So, first of all, let's go to Act 4. I want to turn in some of these cards. And then let's do some prophecies. And then we can call it a day. Alright, let's trade in these cards. Let's trade in the stuff we know. We expect some constant results. A fragment gives a fragment. You know. Nobody's surprised here. We got a Dusk. Okay. The Scholar. We got 40 Wisdom Scrolls. Alright, whatever. The Gem Cutter. We got a GCP. Alright, no surprises. The Gambler. Venter's Gamble. We got the Risk. You know, it could. We're kind of all in on the RNG this league, it seems. The Risk. Oh, we have another mask. Okay, we'll take another mask. How are we looking on them? Emperor's Lux. 4 out of 5. We're getting pretty close. Getting pretty close. Can't wait to get those 5 armor scraps. Alright, let's. I mean, it'd be nice if we can get a Midnight. Nope. Oh well. That's fine. Maps. Get some more pieces. You know, that's cool. There you go. There. Okay. Let us do our one prophecy. Kill the Gemling Legionnaires in the Warehouse District. Warehouse District. Let's get out of here. While wearing Azimite Peak. I can do that. What do I have here? Rallying Cry, Purity of Fire, Iron Will. Iron Will. Okay, let's put Purity of Fire, Rallying Cry. Okay. On this Azimite Peak. And then let's just find them Gemling Legionnaires. This area shouldn't be too hard. I mean, it's level 63. It should be plenty easy. We can just run through everything. Even with a Quicksilver on. Look at that. Oh, this is not the way. I'll take that. Whoa. There's stuff everywhere. A chest of goods. Oh. Okay. Another prophecy complete. I mean, I don't really have the silver coins to fund this. But at the same time, we gotta spam prophecies in order to do our challenges, you know? Or to finish our chains and all that. Alright, let's stop dilly-dallying. Okay. Gemling, Legionnaire. So typically on the corner over here. Yep, on the northeast corner. So we just got the upgraded Azimite whatever. Let me take a look. So Azimite hold cannot evade enemy attacks? No, cannot be stunned. Is that what it gives you? Maybe? I don't know. Either way, prophecy complete. Let's get out of here. Let's put these back on. Azimite hold. Okay. Let's put that here. I got 40 wisdom scrolls over here. And then we can pick up a couple more prophecies. Ancient foes open new paths. Hidden, sure. And the beautiful guide. You will greatly enhance the quality of a map with a single chisel. Ooh, this is not bad. We can chisel up a precinct or something. It's not a bad idea. It basically means we can chisel a yellow map. Right? Wait, what am I doing? Take this back for now. Okay. Let's put away all of our currency. Let's ID a couple items. Which stash tab do I want to ID? Let's ID some shields. That might be fun. Is this? Let's ID all of these over here. And let's see. Nope. Nope. I can't even tell what's good and what's bad anymore. They don't seem that good though. All right. Alright, we ID'd a bunch of shields, a bunch of crappy shields. I mean, let's sell this bow too, it's pretty useless as well. And we are at the 30-minute mark. It's going to be a bit of a shorter episode, but I think going forward, a bunch of our episodes are going to be like this. You know, we're targeting specific challenges at this point. You know, reaching level 90, that's a lot of grinding as well. You know, it's baby steps, gotta get the goals one by one, right? But that's actually the end of this episode. Thank you guys very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, as always, you can leave a like and subscribe to my channel for more updates in the future. Otherwise, keep in touch, guys, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.